Les questions socialement
QSVs,
vives, que nous utilisons
questions socialement
QSV,
vives in French, refer to societal issues, and they are emerging questions which trigger debates in our society. Are they an important stake for the future of our society? Societal issues that are connected to the environment and nature are numerous. Sometimes this leads to heated discussions when people will fight, and this will lead even to civil disobedience phenomena. There have been fights against OGMs or nuclear plants, or José Bové's action regarding bad eating habits, or people plowing out GMOs from the fields. And there are many other such-like questions connected with the environment, with the protection of our landscape. More recently, problems regarding the Sivens Dam or the building of an airport project in the Land area, or the 1,000 cow farm, Ferme des Mille Vaches in French, all questions which are French but also go beyond our French borders, problems that where there are difficulties finding solutions. What are the social issues, the environmental issues connected with sustainable development, these QSVs? They can be connected with a number of fields, agricultural matters, or kinds of agricultures, organic agriculture, biodynamic agriculture. The question of green algae in Brittany is a very good example, or the example of the reintroduction of bears in the Pyrenean mountains, or wolves who are increasingly numerous in some areas, and the disappearance of bees are so many questions that lead to controversies and difficulties. It's very difficult to understand which solutions can be found. There are energy issues, fuels derived from plants, windmills, bisphenol A, and the effect of phone waves on the brain. The example of nanotechnology is also a very good example, because there are consequences in the field of energy, but also consequences for human health and agriculture. From there on, we may wonder about characteristics of QSVs. These societal issues carry a lot of uncertainties. Scientific arguments and discussions are necessary but insufficient to find an agreement on the solution to be applied to the issue. These questions or issues also carry a certain level of risk. It's very difficult to assess what can be the consequences of these problems on our environment, on our natural environment, social environment, economic environment. There are huge stakes at play here. And there are complex issues, interdisciplinary issues. We can't limit ourselves to the experimental sciences that you are familiar with. There are also social sciences at play here, ethics, philosophy, political questions. And we have to acknowledge the fact that these are citizen issues. When we even call them located issues, which means that they find their background in a given space, whereby they can never be reproduced in exactly the same manner elsewhere, and there never is a single solution to be applied to all of them. Take the example of wolves. Wolves are a problem that we also find in Sweden, not only in France. But the problems are different. The context is such that we can never really compare the problem in Sweden and France. And obviously, every time there is a problem with a wolf, it makes the headlines of newspapers, and the situation is described in a dramatic way, and it's very difficult to organize a dialogue between the people who are in favor or against wolves. So what can we do to give an answer to these societal issues when they have to do with the environment? We must think in terms of a functioning process for sciences and knowledge. The pair made by progress in science and technology and science is no longer the perfect marriage that works well. Beck, a German sociologist, shows quite clearly that, yes, sciences are necessary and they allow us to make progress, but by making progress, we also develop new risks, new dangers. For instance, we make progress on nuclear energy, but science thereby created new dangers. And danger perception is also part of the analysis. Mary Douglas, an Anglo-Saxon sociologist, showed quite rightfully that risk perception changes between individuals. People have a greater perception of risks sometimes, but not everybody. And the perception will depend on the culture, on the education. There is a cultural impact on how much people perceive risks and dangers. And we have different players here, stakeholders, and there is also a dynamic. There are various types of knowledge involved here, scientific knowledge, local knowledge, traditional knowledge, professional knowledge regarding bees, for instance, farmers and bee specialists are involved, but also large plants are involved. And there is a map on the controversy map. And we try and understand the interests of the players in the various actions. So all of these problems have an ethical dimension. These are citizen issues. What exactly we as citizens do we want to develop in terms of world? What do we want to fight for? What kind of world do we want to inhabit? And we therefore come to political questions, and we have to wonder about governance in the society on these questions. How are we going to develop interactions between people in order to try and find solutions for these matters? This is absolutely essential. Therefore, the education stakes can be difficult because people want to learn about the environment, but there are very few controversies. We need more scientific concepts. But when we move towards scientific citizenship, then matters such as philosophy, ethical questions become much more important. And this is the reason why there is more interaction, more debate in the education process, in the training process. It's not just about teaching, it becomes an investigation process in order to encourage greater awareness in the way people make decisions. So what are the values at stake regarding education? There is there are changes in the intensity of empowerment, what the British refer to as empowerment, involvement going to as far as activism or militancy on different dimensions. There is a different dimension in the way people intend to act. They can act at the local level and the collective level. People sometimes are militants, but not necessarily in a critical way, not criticizing what is being done. So the environmental stakes emerging in the QSVs, societal issues, may be the initial approach with the news on the newspapers or the media, but behind those news we have other stakes, ethical, citizen, societal, economic, and the answer to those questions are major stakes on which people need to be trained so that we can build tomorrow's society and the world we want to inhabit tomorrow and the best way to regulate this world.